Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, I want to discuss something weird about how captureless lambdas can capture values. I am sure someone watching this episode will find some way to exploit this, and I hope you do, and I hope you share it in the video comments. Yes, my name is Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. And of course, I do suggest that you hire me to your company for on-site training. But if that is not an option, come to one of the many classes that I offer at various conferences around the world. This episode is sponsored by JetBrains, and I wanted to let you know that I do personally use CLion in my work. I find the refactoring tools to be particularly valuable. The safe delete feature has saved me a ton of time when I've been doing refactoring on large projects. And great news, everyone! As of May 7th of this year, JetBrains has decided to make CLion free for non-commercial use. Be sure to check out the video description for more details on that. Let's go ahead and make a very simple example here. I am going to have this function that returns an integer reference. Sure, let's do that. Now, this is something that so many people get wrong. If I have a const expr int that is equal to some value, and I return this integer from this function, I am returning a reference to a local variable. Const expr has absolutely nothing to do with object lifetime. It talks about object initialization, and it can make the value into a constant expression. But that's a different topic. Well, it is related to this topic. I'm going to go ahead and turn optimizations back on this. We can see that the compiler is warning us, warning, reference to local variable I returned. Const expr objects are local objects that do have their own lifetime. If I wanted to make this thing so that I can safely return it, I'm going to make it const expr static. And this is actually a best practice. I actually have this as a best practice in my C++ best practices book, where I say, you probably didn't mean const expr, you probably meant const expr static, and therefore you can treat it like a compile time constant like this. Let's look at this another way. Now I'm going to get a lambda. And I'm going to have a local integer I. And if I try to return a lambda that knows how to simply return the value I, like this, let's rename this to get lambda. No, let's make it get int maker. It's an int maker. This is a compile time error because I am trying to return a variable that was not captured. We don't have automatic implicit capture in C++ with our lambdas and our closure objects. So I might do this, where I capture this thing by reference. But now again, I am getting a really weird warning from GCC. It has this whole I is used uninitialized nonsense because it only tracks these errors dead well. Anyhow, let's put this on Clang because Clang is slightly more consistent about how and where it generates these lifetime errors, but Clang is also it's less specific in some ways and more specific in other ways. Whatever, it's going to do what I want it to do here. See address of stack memory associated with local variable I returned. Boo, that's bad. We don't want to do that. Let's go ahead and look at the size of this lambda. And we should still get a warning from the compiler here because I am actually capturing a variable by reference and that variable's lifetime has ended on line 5. The size of this lambda is 8. Okay, I'm going to make I here const expr. And I, have leftover warning flags from previous iterations of episodes that I was recording. Let's go ahead and disable those. I have a capture by reference. Now, I just told you that a const expr variable is scoped to the lifetime of this function, but the compiler is still able to do this code without actually capturing it. The size of this lambda is now 1. 1 byte is not enough to hold an integer. But somehow I can return this non-captured, captured constexpr variable whose lifetime has already ended. This doesn't make sense. Now I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this capture. And I covered part of this in the stupid constexpr tricks episode that I did a while back. So this is a lambda that has access to a local constexpr variable without actually having increased the size of the lambda. That's very weird. That variable basically ceases to exist and yet is there doing its job. Let's make this a little bit bigger, shall we say. Let's go ahead and make a constexpr array and see just how far this goes. Now it says variable data cannot be implicitly captured in a lambda with no capture default specified. Why not? This is a constexpr variable as well. It says I can capture by reference, I can capture by value, etc., etc. Let's put it back on GCC and see if GCC has a problem with this. Okay, GCC doesn't have a problem with this. Now, my understanding is that this should be allowed as GCC is allowing it. This might be a bug in Clang, or it might be a misunderstanding on my part. But notice that this thing is still returning 1 for its size. Let's go ahead and create an object of type data. Okay, set but not used. So it's unused variable warning. Sure, whatever. Turn some value in the middle of this thing. 0 is being returned. That's correct. This whole thing is being optimized away. We need a function that is explicitly not implemented, because remember, this is a great trick to play with Compiler Explorer. We declare functions and don't implement them, and then we try to do something with those things. So I have this local copy of this array, and I'm going to pass it to useArray. So what is going to happen here? At some point, this data has to be materialized, generating the code to make a zero initialized array from somewhere. Let's go ahead and further complicate this. I'm going to initialize this array object with, no, let's not do that. That's more, way more, well, what the heck, why not? Just to prove a point. Okay, some sort of pseudo randomly generated nonsense. Now we see that it has actually created this data table. This is not static data, but the compiler has made it static data somehow. Let's go ahead and look again at the size of this lambda. And we have unreachable code. I don't know if the compiler is going to yell at me. I'll comment it out. Okay, the size of this lambda is still 1. Let's go back to Clang. Clang is still going to tell me that I can't implicitly capture this thing. And let's capture by reference. And now it says address of stack memory associated with this thing. If we copy it by value, are we going to get... Yeah, so now it thinks the size of the lambda is 40. Who is right here? We're going to go straight to the source, the C++ standard, and try to figure out who is right. Well, I can't find the wording on that, so let's try something slightly different. I am going to just create a constexpr array of integers, like this. This is not going to be a C++ array anymore. So now this lambda is returning a pointer. Then, and this is just wrong. It captured, well, let's get rid of the explicit capture. Warning, address of stack memory associated. I can't find the wording on this. Maybe you can find the wording on it. It's a bit of a mystery to me. I really feel like GCC is the one doing the right thing. Let's go ahead and try one last thing and see if Visual Studio is going to get a vote on this. Visual Studio says that it cannot access that data. Okay, I just had a realization that I actually had a typo in my code when I tried to compile with Visual Studio. So I just updated things so that it is actually correct code and does compile on Visual Studio. So as far as I can tell, Clang is the only compiler that rejects this, so I'm pretty sure it's a bug in Clang. But this is just fascinating possibilities. I never had to declare this variable static anywhere, but it implicitly ends up having basically a static scope. The compiler deals with materializing these values when it needs to. Anyhow, thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Do something interesting with this. Leave a comment. Tell me if you can find the language in the standard that allows or disallows this. And otherwise, thank you for watching.